how to create the fur effect for text or for shapes in Photoshop. That's the topic we are going to talk about today. Here I'm going to show you the simple basic technique how to apply the fur effect on your text or shapes. And once you get the technique, you can apply this effect to any text or any shape you desire. So, alright, so here we have got a white texture background, and then I have got this texture, fur texture here. So I'm going to click the text tool and I'm going to type a single letter T. Go to edit and transform it nice and big. Now I'm going to press Control or Command from the keyboard and click on the text layer, and then you get this nice selection of the text. I'm going to turn off this text layer now, and I have this nice selection. I select the first texture layer and I click on this mask icon. Now you can see the fur into this T shapes. Now I'm going to press B from the keyboard to select the brush, and here you need to go to, if you are using the newer version of Photoshop, you need to go to setting, a small icon, just click on it and then go to legacy brushes. So what it does, it will load the legacy brush from the Photoshop, and if you are using the older version of Photoshop, you already have these brushes in the brushes panel by default. So I'm going to press OK and I drag it down, and here I see this legacy brush panel. So I open this panel and here I'm looking for, go to default brushes. Here I'm looking for a specific brush which helped me create the fur effect. So drag it down and you see there is a brush there called this one, Dune Brush. So select this one. So let me create a new layer to show you how this brush works. I'm going to turn off this layer for now. Let me show you how this brush basically works. So if I start painting here, you can see how this brush is basically working. It's basically a mixture of white and black color. So basically what it's doing is taking color from the foreground and the background, and it's mixing up both together and creating a nice gloss effect. So if you click on this brush setting, you will see all those settings related to brush into this panel. So in my case, I am getting two colors from this brush and I only need one color. So what I will do, I will turn off this color dynamics option. So what it will do now, let me remove this one creating there. So if I paint, now you see I'm only getting a single color, and this is what I want. So brush is selected, color is selected, what's next? Now if I turn on my original layer, if I select the mask and I paint on it, you will see we are getting the nice fur effect, but the brush is too big. So in order to reduce the size of the brush, we click on this panel and here you can reduce the size. Okay, we are happy with the size now. So if I paint on the top, or make sure you select this mask. So if I paint on the top, you see we are getting this nice effect. But the problem here is we are having different angles of the fur. It's not constant in one angle. So some of the hairs going on that way and some of the hair are going in a different direction. So we need to change our brush direction according to fur. So how do we do that? So if you click on this brush panel right here, here you can see, click on this brush tip, and here you will see the direction and size of the brush. So how do we change the direction? So if you click on this icon and go to, now this is the size of the brush, and here you can flip it. If I increase the size a bit, you see I can flip it. Here we go, you see now the brush is flipped, and you can unflip it like this way. Let me press Ctrl Z, and same thing go with the other vertical. So you can flip it horizontal and you can flip it vertical. So now I'm going to decrease the size. This is too small. Increase it a bit. Yeah, that should be fine. Put the spacing between 3 to 5% and close this panel. Select the mask, and now I'm going to paste with this brush on the mask. You see that we are getting the nice direction of the fur out of the text, and that's how we want it to be. And if you want to make it more thicker, you can paint into that area again. Now there's one problem here. You need to keep changing the direction of the brush depending on the fur. So what can we do about it? So if you click on this brush settings and click on the shape that dynamics and click on this angle jitter control, click on this one and click on the directions. Now what happens when you paint on it, the brush direction will change accordingly. Now if I paint with my brush, you see what happens. Now you can see the direction of my brush, but when I paint it, it will get changed. Here we go. Here you see how what is happening here. So the brush is changing the direction by itself. If you want to do that manually, this is how it works. But if you want to let Photoshop do it for you, let me show you how it works. So I'm going to press Ctrl Z all the way back to where it was. Sorry. Now we are back to square one. So we go down further, text there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Ctrl or Command from the keyboard and click on this mask. So I get this nice selection there. If I turn this layer off, you can see that's the selection I have. So what I will do, I go to this path panel. If you can't see the path here, you can go to window and the path should be, this is the path. So you can select the path from there. And in the path panel with the selection on, you click on this icon. So what it will do, it will create the path for you. Now you see the path has been created. Now go back to the layers and make sure you select the mask. Note the layer, make sure you select the mask. These white lines should be on the mask. That means the mask is selected. Now select the pen tool from the side and right click on the path. And here you can select the stroke path. And from this drop down menu, you have to select the brush and press OK. You see what it done? So basically Photoshop has applied all those affected that we have selected from the brush panel onto the edges of the mask or the path we have selected. So now you get the idea how this process works. So let me open another example for you to create this effect into a new file. So in this example, we have go our background layer and then we have three different layer of fur and then we have our text on the top. So I'm going to press Ctrl or Command from the keyboard and click on this text or T icon and I get the selection of the text. So I'm going to turn off that text layer and select the fur layer and click on the mask icon. And now you see our fur mask has been created. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply the same technique what we just learned. So I'm going to press Ctrl and get another selection by pressing Ctrl or Command from the keyboard and click on the text. We have both the selection and we go to path and then we click on this icon and we have both the path there. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to press P to select the pen tool and right click on the path and then I click on the stroke path. Now here's one thing you need to keep in mind. The settings we have applied, we need to select those settings all the time whenever we need to apply this technique. So you need to set the size of the brush, directions, turn off the dynamics and pick up the relevant brush. So when you have selected all those things, then you apply this technique and it will apply according to what we are looking for. So I'm going to select brush from here and then press OK. And boom, we have created this nice fur effect. So I'm going to remove this part by pressing escape from the keyboard twice and we have this nice fur layer. Now if I double click on this layer and go to layer style and click on this drop shadow and we got this nice drop shadow here. Now we are going to apply all this effect to make this text more nice or realistic. And I play around with it, then I add some pose and bevel with it. After a few tweaks of layer style, I have come up with this final fun effect. So that's it guys, I hope this tutorial helped you in some way. And if you have any question, feel free to drop the line into the comment section. If you have come to my channel, please do consider subscribing and hit the like button. This video helps me in some ways. That's it for now and I'll see you next video. Bye now.